KMJQ Houston Galveston. Behind the Magic.
Hey!
With James Brown.
Get up! Get on up! Get up! Get on up!
Soul music is the truth. It's telling it like it is. Without being dressed up, it's life in the raw.
James Brown.
This is a man's world.
On the People Station. Magic 102.1.
You got your highest eagles on. Slipping new. Got your highest sneakers on, and you're slipping new. You're more than all right. You know you're out of sight. You got a shapely figure, mama, that's keeping you up tight. You got a shapely figure, mama, keep me up tight. Know you're out of sight. Hey, the way you do the thing you do, the way you kiss me too, the way you do the thing you do, the way you kiss me too, my heart delight, that's what you are. You know you're out of sight.
James Brown released the song Cold Sweat in 1967, and it picked up where Out of Sight and Papa's Got a Brand New Bag left off. Its offbeat rhythmic feel was something that had never been done in popular music. Still building on the evolution of funk, the song was written by Brown's bandleader, Alfred Pee Wee Ellis, who said in an interview that the song was actually influenced by Miles Davis's So What? Ellis wrote the song on a bus ride from New York to Cincinnati, and once they arrived at King Record Studios, they recorded the whole 7-minute song in one take.
My band, when they play people, they can't get the people off to sit down because the things that we do, you know, they're so different, you know, because they're unwritten stuff. See, we changed the musical structure in 1965 with Papa's Got a Brand New Bag, because music was written on 2 and 4. And on the up-tempo. And now we play it on the downbeat, which is totally different.
You're listening to Behind the Magic on the People Station, Magic 102.1.
I don't care about your past.
1968, James Brown experienced some personal tragedies. The death of Sid Nathan, his boss at King Records, Lil Willie John, a personal inspiration, and Ben Bart, his business mentor and father figure. Not only that, King Records had been sold twice in just 2 months. That same year, Martin Luther King and presidential candidate Robert F. Kennedy were assassinated, adding to the tension built up by the Vietnam War and the civil rights struggle. The day after Martin Luther King was killed, Brown performed a televised concert to a rowdy crowd at Boston Garden. He was able to calm the crowd down by promoting unity and peace.
There were a few cultural figures who were dominant enough with their voices and had outreach enough to try to make some impact. I mean, people were going in their anger and frustration from reacting to genocide, to suicide, and self-destruction. And those who had voices to reach them, who had the courage to do so, did reach out. But James did not just say, please don't riot. He tried to turn some of that pain into, as it were, burn, baby, burn, to Bill, baby, Bill.
You're listening to Behind the Majic with James Brown. On Magic 102.1.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, everybody up there.
Station Magic 102.1.
Yeah.
James Brown was the consummate showman, and the only thing more exciting than listening to a James Brown record was to see him and his band live.
Everybody would like to know what we're doing, how we get into it. It's soul, something that is spiritual. Soul is life. Soul is everyday movement. It's what we feel, where we're at. Spiritual, you got it. God has all control of the movement of what we do on the stage.
We'll be back with more Behind the Magic with James Brown.
Baby, baby, I got the feeling.
On the People's Station, Magic 102.1.